Master. To kickstart the conference, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the stage President of RSA, Mr. Amit Yoran.
Welcome to RSA Conference APJ. It's fantastic to be back here in beautiful Singapore. And it's great to see the Minister of Homeland Affairs launch the National Cybercrime Action Plan. We've been hosting our APG conference here in Singapore for 4 years now. And I'm happy to tell you that in 4 years, we've built up quite a bit of momentum. This year, we anticipate over 5,000 attendees. That's a feat that took our San Francisco conference more than 8 years to achieve. We have over 100 organizations in the exhibit hall displaying some of the industry's best cybersecurity solutions. It's amazing to see the global cybersecurity community growing at such an incredible rate to address the world's most critical threats. And we have our work cut out for us. But first, we need to make sure that we're looking at the same problem. Today, I want to talk to you about perspective. We all process data every second. We subconsciously filter and categorize the things that we observe based on what's important to us and our own perspective. Artists often notice minute details of a city block, the nuanced variations in color, and the way the light bounces off the glass. Engineers prioritize data points that tell them about the structural integrity of a building, and futurists imagine the potential for that city block 10, 20, and 30 years down the road. Each of our personal experiences helps to form our unique perspective. I just flew in from Washington, D.C., where perspectives are sometimes skewed. One recent poll of perspectives claims that nearly 70% of Americans would say that their Trump presidency would make them anxious. And the other 30% said that a Trump presidency would make them Canadian. Now, as security professionals, we're suspicious of new technologies. But we also know that technology serves as the greatest leverage point for all organizations. It determines efficiency, competitiveness, and can even transform markets and industries fundamentally. It is foundational for defense, intelligence, and civil service. And technology isn't static. It's constantly shifting and evolving and progressing. And organizations now realize that they must embrace this new reality or become obsolete. Hopefully, all of our data points and analysis lead us to share that common perspective. Our perspectives, though, of the path forward and what actions we need to take, they still vary dramatically. Let me give you an example of how powerful perspective can be and how it can shape our actions and outcomes. Who's heard of Dick Fosbury? Well, with the Olympics just around the corner, I thought I would share his story as a great analogy for us to consider. See, Dick was a U.S. high jumper in the 1960s, and he stunk. I mean, he was absolutely terrible. In one interview, he said that he was the worst high jumper in his entire club. But Dick was open-minded. He was able to change his perspective based on what was happening around him and ultimately change his actions and results. See, before 1960, high jumpers would land in sawdust pits. Those cushy mats that we use today, they hadn't yet been invented. And so high jumping techniques required that you land on your feet. Those soft landing pads, they started showing up about the time Dick was a teenager. And while most high jump athletes continue to do their scissor jumps or Western rolls, Dick began to look at things from a different perspective. If the mats were soft enough to not have to land on your feet, why not change the way you jump? So Dick pioneered a new technique by throwing himself over the bar, head and shoulders first, and landing on his back. And to this day, that technique is called the Fosbury Flop. This allowed Dick's center of gravity to be distributed, giving him a longer period of time to get over the bar. Well, he caught the world's attention in the 1968 Olympics when he brought home the gold and shook a lot of people's minds. A new piece of technology, the mats, it gave high jump athletes the opportunity to think differently. But they still had to make the choice to do so. And no one did, except Dick. And he won, because he was the first person to take advantage of the new landscape and change his technique. And subsequently, athletes continued to hone on his style. But Dick was first. He acted smarter than his competitors. And that's something that all of us need to do. So to change our thinking, let's start with a few common facts. According to Gartner, $75 billion were spent in cybersecurity in 2015 alone. Gartner also projects that by 2020, 60% of enterprise information security budgets will be allocated to rapid detection and response approaches. That 60% is up from less than 10% in 2014. Also, in RSA's own research, here's today's reality. Over 70% of organizations in APJ report that they've been successfully compromised by an intrusion in the last 12 months. And I'm willing to bet that many of the remainder aren't able to detect the fact that they've become victims. Security incidents are growing at 66% year over year. And 56% of companies say that it's unlikely or highly unlikely that they'd be able to detect a sophisticated attack. RSA's research reveals that 90% of organizations in APJ are not satisfied with how quickly they can detect and investigate an attack. The definition of insanity is continuing to do the same thing over and over again and hoping for different results. In other words, if we want to change our results, we need to change our perspective and act differently. Today, we're dealing with focused adversaries, with creativity, patience, and persistence. They're unpredictable, with a wide range of tools at their disposal. They'll orchestrate their attacks until they are successful. Remember, we're dealing with human beings, with a tremendous amount of ingenuity. That can be a very powerful thing. Because of the protections that we've deployed, our adversaries have chosen to view their challenge differently. And they're moving at blazing speed. In looking at all the breaches over the past few years, our adversaries aren't beating us because they have better technology. They're using the same mats we are. They're beating us because they've succeeded in evolving. So shouldn't we? We're not going to magically find the next great firewall, sandbox, or host armament that's actually going to prevent the adversaries from getting in our environments. The path forward requires heavy lifting. But why aren't we doing it? Well, maybe it's because the choices in front of us are confusing. Or maybe it's because it means that choosing to do something different than what everybody else is doing. But different results are going to require us to start by being courageous. Let me throw out another number to you. 80%. Based on a number of separate research studies, between 75% and 85% of CISOs are reevaluating their security strategies over the next 12 to 18 months. Why? Because more and more, cybersecurity is moving into the boardroom. Executives and boards are asking more questions than ever before. With all the money they're spending, they want to know, what is the business impact should a breach happen? And this is just as true in government and public sector. Today's business and security, they're at an inflection point. If we don't build better strategies to detect and respond to today's advanced threats, we're going to lose. Just like all those other high jumpers in the 1968 Olympics. Let's change this game together. Let's change our perspective. Let's do things differently, just like Dick. Let's think beyond the false hope that we'll get security from perimeters, from signature-based technologies, logging, and SIM solutions, hoping they'll protect us, when we know they won't. CISOs want to understand to what degree security incidents will impact business continuity, intellectual property, and damage to their reputations. Here are a few new requirements. We need a perspective that leverages new levels of visibility, that can provide certainty around what's happening in our environments, not just hunches. We need the perspective made available from new analytic and detection methodologies, ones that take advantage of improved visibility and help identify anomalies in the network, on systems, and in end-user behaviors. This gives us the speed of insight to take the right actions. And we need our perspectives to be informed by business context around IT security issues. What matters to the organization? The truth is that CEOs and boards of directors, they don't care whether the breach was caused by an Angular toolkit based on a vulnerability in Internet Explorer. What they do care about is the overall impact to their business. We need to unite the details of security with the language of business. The core of this new perspective on cybersecurity is the need to provide better, comprehensive insight, more insight than provided by legacy tools and systems. This new perspective, it is the path forward. This is what we call business-driven security. Now, the net-net is that the next generation of cybersecurity technologies, ones that RSA is developing, and ones being developed from some of the innovative vendors out on the expo floor, we need them to move our industry forward. to provide us better, more complete perspective. Gone are the day of point products trying to address a thin sliver of cybersecurity. Today, our adversaries are persistent, using combinations of techniques in an orchestrated fashion. For today's standard attack campaign, point solutions are as flawed by conceptual design and as barren in value as antivirus products and intrusion detection systems. With the right visibility, advanced analytics holds great promise for our future. At RSA, we've released several new analytic methods and are driving some awesome results. But let me be clear, there are no magic solutions to our challenge. Big data, machine learning, behavioral analytics, these are all great marketing concepts, and we can apply those technologies to further our cause. But they are not to be confused with an advanced threat strategy any more than sandboxing should be. Tools alone won't win the battle for us. We need super smart, creative humans. We need you. I like to think of cybersecurity tools as things like ropes, ice axes, carabiners, all the necessary tools when hiking a glacier. You know, the kind of stuff we do out here in Singapore. Sure, these are gonna help us on the ice, but they're not gonna get us to the top. You need to don them and you need to use them effectively for your advantage. But it starts with a vision and the courage to take on a seemingly dauntless challenge. Let me share a personal story with you. My daughter, when she was 5 years old, her favorite word was why. Why? Why? And let me tell you, that drives you crazy as a parent. But don't lose that sense of curiosity, that desire to hunt down an answer, the need to chase things down to ground truth, the willingness to gain a different perspective. Be that annoying five-year-old. Be relentless. Wear your adversary down with your whys. And as you build your cybersecurity strategy, acquire and analyze data points that support one perspective or another. Draw lines, make correlations, connections, paint the full picture. Look at the entire landscape and look for outliers. Look for anomalies. Look for things that conflict with your assumptions. And as you figure out your organization's point of view and determine what data points you see when you look at that city block, do what Dick Fosbury did and ask yourself, how can a new Matt act as an advantage for us? And when you answer that question, ask it again and again and again. Why? Never settle. Don't be afraid to make a shift in your perspective and change your point of view. Stop relying solely on technologies trying to prevent an incident. It's time to look at things from a different angle. It's time to create a cybersecurity program that links breaches and threats with how they impact your business or government entity. It's time to form a better strategy driven by the organization's business needs. It's time to gain a different perspective. Now, I've been in cybersecurity for about 25 years, with a vast majority of that in network monitoring and hardcore incident response work, helping unsuspecting organizations come to grips with the ugly reality of a breach. helping people gain perspective and clarity on what the dirty, dark world of cyber really looks like. Obviously, I'm highly opinionated. I've got a lot of scars based on those experiences. But I feel like I owe it to the industry and owe it to you to share my perspective. So before I wrap up, I want to take a step back, and I wanted to thank you personally. The work that we do matters. It matters each and every single day to the entire world. It matters to our organizations, it matters to our customers, it matters to our employees, it matters to our partners, and it matters to our families. None of today's modern world, none of humanity's potential for the future, our efforts in nano, in space, in medicine, in transportation, in power and enlightenment, none of it can be achieved if we collectively aren't successful in cyber. When you go back to work every day, I want you to think and remember that what you do matters. When you search for elevated perspective at the RSA conference over the next few days, and what your Fosbury flop jumping style is going to look like, I want you to remember that what you do matters. Now, I know many of you struggle with red tape or leadership that doesn't yet understand the difference or appreciate the difference of how your efforts are different from regulatory compliance regimes. Don't be discouraged and don't give up. The work that you do matters. Thank you.